Hey professionals, do you ever have the thought, I'm not good enough, I'm a fraud, and I'm going to get found out? Well, that's called imposter syndrome, and in this video we're going to explore why that thought lies to people and how to relax out of it so that you can act more confidently. My name's Steve, and I coach professional people just like you to combine your personal brilliance with unshakable emotional freedom. And a good place to start is by downloading my free, simple, 5-step guide to mastering stress in the moment. Now, picture this. You're in the senior job, or you've got a new gig. You have responsibilities. You have ideas. But suddenly you think, what if my ideas are silly? What if saying them will show me up? What if I'm really not good enough? Is this where I get found out for being a fraud? Now, before we get going, the rest of this video is based on an assumption. The assumption that you are capable in your work, you just don't always see it. This is definitely not the video for people who are genuinely trying to fake it till they make it. And by the way, this particular video is for a friend of mine who needed to hear this earlier this week. Now, the first point I want to get across is that imposter syndrome is an example of what I call suspicious thinking. Thinking that puts an idea before the mind that invites us to explore that idea that is negative, that is suspicious about us and our abilities and our motivations. And that thought only gets credence because when we put ideas before the mind, we tend to go down a rabbit hole with those thoughts. We tend to go in deep with them as if they're all that there is. Just like if I get involved with the thought that the world is a bad place, then my attention will narrow shoot down only on examples of how the world is a bad place. I'll think that's all there is. I won't see everything outside. I won't be able to cross-examine the idea. And similarly, if I think the world is simply a good place, then again, my attention will funnel down on how the world is a good place, and I'll think that's all there is. The useful thing to do here is to come back out of that rabbit hole, to stop being narrow focused on the one thought. And what that requires is an awareness that that's what we're doing and enough presence of mind to interrupt ourselves and pull ourselves out of that rabbit hole so that you can look outside of that narrow chute of that thought and look at what else is out there, which in this context, maybe to look at the things that you have succeeded at, the work you have completed, and the people who have complimented you on that work. And to put other thoughts before the mind, such as, instead of, what if I'm not good enough? What if I am? Instead of, what if I fail? What if I can make a useful contribution? My second tip is to put it into perspective. Statistically, 70% of people have imposter syndrome thoughts. That means that in any room of 10 people, 7 of them are going to be people who have imposter syndrome thoughts. And they probably think that they're the only one. But look at them, each one in turn, and consider, there's a good chance you have imposter syndrome thoughts too. That's because it's so common, it's so normal. And when you have that awareness about how common it is, then it becomes clear that it cannot be a realistic symbol of our real ability. It makes it easy to see that that thought is not the truth speaking, but a common, misleading, inwardly facing, ego-oriented cognitive bias. We are all subject to cognitive biases, a lot of them. And although we can't become superhuman so that we're not subject to them, we can become aware of them, we can become conscious of them, we can develop the presence of mind to be aware when they're playing so that we can interrupt them. And in fact, on my laptop here, I have the names of some people who suffer from imposter syndrome. Listen to these. Kate Winslet, Natalie Portman, Ryan Reynolds, Jodie Foster, Meryl Streep, Lady Gaga, Tom Hanks, Penelope Cruz, Jessica Chastain, Serena Williams. Now, if Serena Williams, the greatest female tennis player of all time, can get imposter syndrome, then you can get it too. And it shows that as a thought, it is definitely a liar. By the way, if you're enjoying this video so far, do give it the thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the notifications bell so that you'll know when new content arrives. Now, my fourth point is to understand that the reason you get imposter syndrome thoughts is because you have the notion of an idealized person performing this role. Somebody who is perfectly trained, somebody who would get 100% on any test on this subject. Somebody with tons of authority, tons of experience, tons of knowledge, knows everything, and knows how to deal with every possible situation. And in the context of thinking of this imaginary perfect person, we're too preoccupied with the thought of the chinks in our armor, the fact that we don't know everything, the fact that we don't get 100%, the fact that there are experiences that we haven't had. And while we're narrow shooting our thoughts down the chinks in our armour, we're looking sidewards at other people and seeing their highlights reel, the things that they do good. Well, think about that for a moment. That is you comparing your lowlights reel with everybody else's highlights reel and looking up to a perfect person, who, by the way, doesn't exist. But the fact of the matter is, you have a highlights reel too, and they have chinks in their armour too. The fact is, we are all mostly similar to each other. It's just that we make the thinking error of doing false, uneven comparisons. And we don't need to be perfect. We don't need to be 100%. And that's good, because nobody is. And my fifth and perhaps most important point is to take the attention off yourself and put it onto the work that you do. The fact of the matter is, people aren't thinking about you as much as you think they are. And in fact, they're probably not thinking about you and not judging your work at all. You see, this isn't about you. This is about the fact that there is work to be done and people who need that work, people who would be served by that work. Now, when you take all the attention off of you and what you think people might be thinking about you, and by the way, they aren't, and instead you put your attention on the work to be done, the way that you can serve, the way that you can contribute today, that's a completely different thing. So instead of thinking, what if I'm not a good enough software engineer, think, there is some code to be written today, and I'm the one who's here to do that. And if we make a mistake, or if we hit the limits of what we know, there are people to ask, there are people to go to, and it's a learning opportunity. Now, if you get imposter syndrome, there's a good chance that you also get overwhelmed from time to time. So as a bonus tip, watch this video up here. Or if you've already watched that video, then watch this one down here instead. This is Steve, wishing you health and happiness.